All right, I am back with the Flightscope Mevo Plus, and I am upgraded to the 0.09 beta firmware. I've been doing some testing. The developers have been collecting data and tweaking the firmware to try to adapt to all the various simulator environments that the Mevo Plus would be put in. So based on different turf and, you know, different layouts, whether a ball has some bounce in it, and how it's rolling, they're trying to adjust the firmware to better accommodate for the most accurate putts, you know, across those different environments that it may be put in. So I've been doing some testing. I figured I would show everybody probably the most common putt that everyone's looking at, you know, just outside of a 10-foot gimme. So I've got it set up to 10 feet, 4 inches here. And I've just been doing some, you know, putting straight towards the screen. My Mevo Plus is 7 feet behind the ball, and I'm 10 feet to the screen. So here you go. Oh, I got lucky on that. I saw that ball hit left of center. Pretty good speed, but that was definitely just left of center. It let me squeeze it in there. So you'll notice on the Mevo that it actually changes color when it's ready to read for a putt, and that's what I've been noticing. I was going to ask the developers, you know, how that works, but basically, it will be blue, and then I can see it change to yellow to read a putt. So, I think once or twice as it was, you know, showing me my data, you know, I hit a putt, you know, way too fast, and it wasn't ready, and so I did get a complete misread, but I think it was because I was jumping the gun, because really, since then, that one's a little hard and tiny right. It let me squeeze it in there. That was just right of center, and I had a little bit too much speed on that, but you can see, I mean, it's working the way it should. You know, if you're hitting it center of the screen, it's a flat surface area, and it has you aligned to break. So it's all about speed, and it's all about hitting the dead center of the screen. Look at that, three in a row. Hopefully this gives you a good idea of, you know, how much things are progressing with the Mevo Plus. The developers have been great. They've been, you know, taking data, taking, you know, user feedback, which is the most important thing in my opinion, because think of the various simulator environments. I mean, there could be people with different turf, you know, and oof, I lifted that one out. Finally got the best of me. And that was just a little left, so, you know, that makes total sense. I mean, I'd be more than happy to show, you know, some different distances if that helps. Obviously, you can see the 10-foot putt is working really well. I mean, we can probably just set up like a 20-foot putt. These are definitely tough to, so how about that? How about 20 feet? I mean, I don't care what anybody says. If you're someone that's on my level, I don't make a lot of 20-foot putts, so don't expect me to be sinking these. Obviously, it's a lot easier just putting, you know, dead center to the screen, but even if you just pull or push just a little bit, it's going to be off. The speed's the most important. That should be relatively close. Yeah, I got a little heat on it. So it read that 29 feet. And I do have the green stimp at 10. So once again, E6 is sending the speed of the ball and the direction of the ball to E6. Did I say E6? I'm sorry. I may be going backwards there. I got too much going on. The Mevo Plus is sending the data to E6. It's going to take that data, and E6 is going to play it the way that E6 plays it. So I have the green set up to a 10 stimp. So it should be rolling at a 10 stimp based on the speed of this ball. That one's going to be a little left, I think. Yeah. So that hit left to center. I'm trying to hit it like a couple feet past the cup. I seem to be going, you know, five feet past the cup. So let me take a little bit of speed off this thing. it is a flat puck. It's not uphill, so you know, it's pretty easy to carry it, you know, 20 feet when it's flat. That one should be pretty close. Look at that. All right. Finally figured the speed out. That was obviously, you know, right in the center that time. So definitely shows you that if you hit the 20-foot putt properly, looks like it's going to read right. So we can do one more of these real quick. Once again, I'm past the hole. Alright, let's do a different shot here. I feel like that one, you know, and like I said, as they adjust this with these six, I feel like that one might have went a little too far for the speed. I mean, obviously, like I said, we're talking drastic improvement, and I'm not the best putter in the world, that's for sure, but this is giving us a really good idea of how, you know, improved everything is. So just for the heck of it, if people want to test out 5 feet, we can test out 5 feet. You're still going to have to carry the ball far enough for it to read it. And that's where it gets interesting. That's why people usually play 10-foot gimmies on simulators. So, I mean, I'm going to try to carry this thing like, I don't know, 3/4 of the way to the screen, I guess. And I would imagine you can, you know, get it into the back of that cup if it's straight. Yeah, see, that slow putt. I don't know if it's gonna read, which this could be another enhancement that they work on. So let's just try hitting that just a little bit harder. There you go. So you can definitely do it. I carry that probably as a 10-foot putt, because it says 10 feet. So it can be done. You're definitely just going to have to carry a little more speed. I got lucky on that one. So that was a pretty good example. I mean, I'm kind of putting that thing to where it's, you know, getting 9 feet to the screen, let's call it. I mean, I think that gives everybody a pretty darn good example. I mean, I could show you, I think there's break if I move the ball. I could show you like another 10-foot putt. Or this is a complete flat surface area. So we could exit this round and I could take you to the chip and putt area. I mean, this is obviously drastically different. See if I can get like a, so this is uphill with a break. I mean, this is probably where, as a not the best putter in the world, I'm gonna struggle. So I mean, I'm uphill 3 inches, now I'm 12 feet. Let's just see if I can get this thing. You gotta remember, it aligns you to the break, so I should just be able to hit this, you know, straight, let's call it 13 feet or so. Yeah, I hit that too hard. Yeah, I definitely hit that too hard. Alright. Oh, that probably isn't enough now. Sure enough, it broke heavy on me. I like this stuff. I mean, I'm glad that I'm not hitting the perfect speed, and I'm sure the Mevo Plus isn't perfect per mile per hour yet. You know, I mean, they're going to continue to work on this and collect data. Like I said, this is my turf. This is how much my ball is bouncing. You know, and as that gets perfected to accommodate, you know, the different situations, I know that just based on this latest beta that's being shown here, I mean, this is great. You know, this is a huge improvement just from a simple data collection and, you know, speaking to the developers. It just shows you the, you know, where Flightscope really is. Look at this. I got that speed down that time. Oh, I almost made it. I mean, I haven't missed one putt yet. I'm doing different distances. Hopefully this really answers some people's questions, you know, about the Mevo Plus. And I've been making YouTube videos. I've teamed up with Top Shelf Golf, which you can see the link down in the description. I encourage you that if you're, you know, considering different launch monitors, you know, that link down below, it gets you the great price that you can get on either unit. Free shipping, no tax. Take advantage of that. Those guys have been great over there. And honestly, comment below any questions that you have. I think that, you know, as I'm not selling these, so I'm not a representative of Flightscope. I know a lot of people have asked that. I'm just a ambassador for units that I. Sorry about that. I got cut off. What I was saying was someone called and it stopped the video. So what I was saying was, is I'm just an ambassador for products that I own. I mean, obviously I want to put the effort in to make those products, you know, the best that they can be. You know, so having, you know, some technical knowledge that I have, I'm trying to work with them and, you know, perfect this, and hopefully everyone benefits from that. So, you know, feel free to comment below with questions or concerns, and feel free to reach out to Flightscope. You know, it's support@flightscopemevo.com. And if you have any concerns or questions, you know, share it with them. The team over there has just been incredible. I think they're going to make this thing the best possible it could be. Obviously, it's already very impressive. So I hope this video helped everybody. Have a great day.